In this video, I'm going to show you the quickest and simplest way to set up Steam streaming in RetroPie. Stick around, because you know what time it is. Hey guys, Jonathan here with TechWizTime, where I create technology tutorials and review videos. In this video, I'm revisiting an old topic, and that is Steam streaming through RetroPie. So what I've recently done is I've updated the script that allows you to easily install Steam streaming on a RetroPie installation on a Raspberry Pi. Now this is all possible thanks to a program on there called Moonlight. Now this is an open source program, and you can get that from the links down in the description below, or you can use my script, which I've also included in the description below. How about I stop talking about it and I'll show you. All right, so the first thing you're gonna wanna do is visit my GitHub page on a PC. So this is just to familiarize yourself with what you're looking at and so forth. Gives you a little rundown of the instructions and also any updates that I may do in the future. Now, I've provided the instructions on the GitHub page, but I will run through them with you right now so you can install it fresh. So I've done this on a brand new installation of RetroPie 4.3, which is the latest one available at the time of this video. So once you're in your RetroPie installation, you just need to press F4 on the keyboard to get to the command line prompt. Once in the command line, you will need to download the script that I've written. So to do that, you type in wget, and instead of typing out the full URL, I've actually created a redirected link, which you can go to by visiting https://techwiztime.com/moonlight.sh. So press enter, and this should start downloading the script. If it doesn't, there is a fix which you can apply, which is --no --check. This is just to skip some security checks. So once that's successfully downloaded, what you'll need to type in now is sudo chmod plus x moonlight.sh. What this line of code does, it actually makes the moonlight.sh file executable, so we can execute it from the command prompt. And now that we've done that, we can launch the Moonlight script by typing in sudo --moonlight.sh. So once you've launched the script, you'll be presented with this screen here. So I'll run through each of the menu options here. So number one, we'll go through. So you type in one and press enter. This will now go through and automatically start downloading the files and so forth that it needs, and also doing a quick update. So there's a few steps here. If it does fail at any point, make sure you take note of what step it fails at and leave me a comment down below so I can see if there's some sort of fix that I can create. So eventually it will get to a point where it asks you to put in your computer's IP address. Now this is the computer that has the GeForce Experience installed on it, as well as your version of Steam. So once you've got your IP address, type that in there and press enter. Now what will happen is that the Raspberry Pi will tell you to input a code into your main PC. So write down this code, go over to your main PC and make sure you type that in there correctly and press enter. Once the Raspberry Pi has noticed that that's been typed in, it will go through and continue the installation. Now, once that's all done, it will come up to a screen that says, do you want to reboot? You can say yes or no here. If you say yes, obviously it will reboot, but if you say no, it will go back to the main menu. So by default, it is set to install 1080p and 720p at 30 frames per second and 60 frames per second. So from here, you can actually install the 480p option if you like, by choosing option number four. It should only take a few seconds, and there you go, you've got 480p installed into your RetroPie setup. So to check this, you can press number six and that'll exit the script, and then type exit into the command prompt. From there, if we go to the Steam menu, you can see now that we've got 1080p, 720p and 480p all at 30 and 60 frames per second. Selecting any of these will actually launch it and away you go. But wait, say for example, you don't want the 1080p and the 720p options there. What you can do, you can go back into the command prompt, launch up the script again, and by pressing number three, this will uninstall all the scripts that we've installed so far. And you can install just the 480p option if you like. Now, say for example, you want to resync this Moonlight installation with another PC. All you need to do is go into the Moonlight script and choose option number five. Put in your new PC's IP address and you'll be given a new pairing code for where you can pair with the new PC. It's that simple. But wait, there is one thing that this script does not do, and that is remove the extra Steam menu items if you accidentally do option number one twice or three times. So to show you here, you can see that there are two Steam options there. And unfortunately, the only way to do that is to do that manually. So what you need to do is you need to go to the command prompt and type this command in on the screen right now. This will launch a text editor where you can actually go in and scroll or arrow all the way down to the very bottom and you will see there now that there are actually two options there for Steam. So just remove this section here, and once you've removed it, press Ctrl X, Y, and then Enter. This will save the configuration file, and when you go back into Retropie, you'll notice now that there's only one Steam menu. So that's a quick fix for you guys out there that might have installed it twice and didn't know what to do. So I think I've pretty much covered everything to do with this Moonlight script so far. However, there is room to make this script better. So if you've got any coding skills or you've got any ideas of how to make this just that little bit better, then leave me some comments down below, or even better, on GitHub, branch this release off and do the edits yourself and submit it to me. As a community, we can make this script even better and easier for people to access. So lastly, I just want to say thank you to everyone out there. I'm just about to hit 15,000 subscribers, and it's been an amazing journey so far. And I'm just really grateful for everyone out there in the community that's helped out and likes and shares these videos. If you're not a subscriber to this channel, then make sure you do. And if you are a subscriber, like the many of you that are out there, almost 15,000, then make sure you hit that notifications button so you get notified every time I release a new video. If you're interested in having a chat, then come over to the TechWizTime Facebook group. We've got a whole group of people there. It's almost 100 people now, so that one's growing as well. Have a chat and yeah, talk about different things like Retropie, Raspberry Pi, technology, different gaming things, whatever you want. So with that all said, thank you very much, guys. And as always, imagine, learn, create.